make istighfar 100 times every day. Who said? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I make istighfar for how many times? 100 times. And who is Nabi? Our Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was ma'asoom and pure from guna. He was pure from guna. Quran mentioned when he was alive, and Quran ayat revealed. Para number 26, Surah Fatah, second ayat. لِيَغْفِرْ لَكَ اللَّهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأَخَّرْ. ओ मेरे महबूब सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम, हमने आपके पिछले और अगले सारे गुनाहों को माफ फरमा दिया. We forgive your all previous sins also and your future sins also. So Allah forgive all sins of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But still Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was making istighfar for 100 times every day. So how much we should make istighfar? فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. In Surah Shams, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala mentioned, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala put capability of guna also in human being and capability of taqwa also, taqwa and piety. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. So all human beings have the thought of guna. So when we will come in this world, we are staying in this world, all human beings, they will commit guna. No one can say the waswas and thoughts and waspas of guna don't come to my mind. No one, even awliya also can't say. They also can't say. In every human being, does guna's thought will come. But in Hadith Tirmidhi Sharif Riwayat, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, Kullu bani Adam khata'un. All the children of Adam are sinners. But wa khayrul khata'in at-tawwabun. The best of sinner is that person who make tawbah, who repent. So that one is best sinner. So person who make tawbah. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, Creator Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wa salam, he was staying in Jannah. He was staying in Jannah. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said, wa kula minha ragadan haythu shi'tuma. Whatever you want to eat in just Jannah, you can eat. Wa la taqraba hadhihi shajara fatakuna min al-zalimin. But do not touch the tree, the certain tree. Otherwise, tum to zalimon se ho jaoge, fatakuna min al-zalimin. You will be among those who are doing wrong. So you don't touch this. But Shaitan was in Jannah also, and Shaitan put the waswasa and waswa in his mind, and Hazrat Adam alayhi salatu wasalam touched the tree. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala now chased him away from Jannah. Now the Adam alayhi salatu wasalam came to this world. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told someone dua. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala could forgive him without this dua also. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave medication. What does dua?
رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. او ہمارے رب ظلمنا انفسنا, ہم نے اپنے نفس کے اوپر ظلم کیا ہے. وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا, ہمیں کوئی معاف کرنے والا نہیں ہے. وَتَرْحَمْنَا, ہمارے اوپر رحم کرنے والا بھی نہیں ہے, اگر ہے تو تو ہی ہے. وَرَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. اگر آپ ہمیں معاف نہیں فرمائیں گے تو ہم تو خسارے میں پڑ جائیں گے. Allah forgive us, have mercy upon us. Adam alayhi salatu wa salam made this dua. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accepted his dua and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala forgave him. Why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave this dua? Oh,
Adam, you are going to that world. In this world, all people will commit guna. And if they will commit guna, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala gave two poisons. How many poisons? Two. One is shaitan and one is nafs. One is shaitan and one is nafs. They are our poisoners, our enemy. But Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala gave two medication also. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, Adam alayhi salatu wa salam was going to the dwar. He made mistake. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala gave medication, one dua, Rabbana dhalamna anfusana, and said all human beings will commit guna. The shaitan and nafs, they are enemy of human being, all human being. They will commit guna. But Allah gave two medication also. What? Toba and istighfar. Toba and istighfar. There's two medication Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala gave. So when a person will use this medication, Allah will protect from shaitan and nafs. Remember one thing here. Whatever sicknesses also are in this world, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala created that medication also protects that sickness. And there's a different thing. Sometimes insan and human being's mind doesn't go toward that ilaj, that treatment. But Allah Ta'ala created all medication. Mufti Taqi Usmani wrote in Islami Khutbat, he said when he came to South Africa, Junubi Africa, when he does kitab, they wrote 1993, so it means he came before that time. So he said, I was traveling Cape Town area and I was traveling by a train. This train stopped on mountain area. At mountain area, the train stopped. Now what happened? He said, we went down to read our salah. We went down to read our salah. Now Mufti Taqi Usmani, Damat Barakatuhul Aliyah from Pakistan, he said, we were reading salah and I saw one tree there. One tree. This tree, this plant. I saw a plant. This plant was very beautiful. Its leaves also are very beautiful. So I wanted to touch this plant. This tree's leaf. I wanted to break this leaf. When I spread my hand, so what happened? One person said, Hazrat, don't touch this tree, this plant. I said, why? What happened? I said, no. If you will touch this plant have a lot of poison. This poison will affect your body. How the scorpion will bite a person and it will affect the poison to our body. If you will touch this tree, the poison will affect your body. Don't touch. He said, Allah shukr. Allah tera shukr hai, tune mujhe bacha liya. I thank Allah. Okay, Allah save me. I'm making shukr to Allah. Allah save me. He said, it's better you told me. But if you didn't tell me, it was very dangerous thing. But he said, oh, okay, you told me, that's why I knew. But if other people will come here and they will touch, then they will be in trouble. Then he mentioned one strange thing also. What? Ek ajeeb kudrat ka karishma bhi bataya. What? He said, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala created one another tree also in the root of this plant. If a person will touch this tree, he kept down here, our Saudi Africa. Now, if you will touch the tree and same time a person will touch another tree, this poison will go away. We knew. A person, all sickness we have in this world, but Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala created this medication. So we are talking what? The shaitan and nafs, they are poisonous and they are our enemy. So Adam alayhi salatu wa salam also made mistake. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala gave medication. So thus two things, shaitan and nafs, they are our enemy. They are poisonous. Allah gave two medication also. What? Tawbah and istighfar. तौबा एंड इस्तिगफार. इफ वी विल मेक तौबा वी विल मेक इस्तिगफार. अल्लाह तबाराक व तआला विल प्रोटेक्ट अस फ्रॉम द शैतान इन आवर नफ्स. नाउ व्हाट वी विल डू इन तौबा इन इस्तिगफार, वी शुड मेक तौबा फॉर थ्री थिंग्स. वी शुड मेक तौबा फॉर थ्री थिंग्स. नंबर वन, अपॉन आवर गुना, अपॉन आवर गुना. नंबर टू, वी विल डू एनी गुड अमल, एनी ताआत, एनी इबादत, आफ्टर दैट वी मस्ट मेक तौबा. फॉर एग्जांपल, आफ्टर सलाह, व्हेन वी विल फिनिश आवर सलाह, व्हाट वी विल से? अस्तगफिरुल्लाह, अस्तगफिरुल्लाह, थ्री टाइम्स से अस्तगफिरुल्लाह. व्हाई वी आर सेइंग अस्तगफिरुल्लाह? ओ अल्लाह, हाउ वी शुड फुलफिल द राइट्स ऑफ योर इबादत, वी कुडंट फुलफिल. ओ अल्लाह, please forgive us. Any ibadat, any good deed we will do, after that we should make istighfar, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. Allah forgive me, I can't fulfill your right. So we must make istighfar on those. Number three, we should make istighfar upon our istighfar also. We should make istighfar upon our istighfar also. We don't know how to make istighfar also. We are making istighfar, we are reading astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, but our mind going somewhere else. Our mind going somewhere. We should make istighfar upon our istighfar also. Ya Allah, I don't know how to make istighfar also. Please forgive me. Number one, what? Make istighfar upon our tawbah. Number two, upon ta'at, any ibadat, any good amal we will do, any righteous deed we will do, we should make istighfar. Allah, we can't fulfill the rights of your ibadat. Number three, we should make istighfar upon our istighfar. Any tawbah. One is istighfar, one is tawbah. What is different? Istighfar means ask for forgiveness. Ask for forgiveness, according to some ulama. Ask for forgiveness. And tawbah means promise, I won't commit this guna again. So now this question comes in our mind. Okay, one thing other than we have to tell you, what is tawbah also? There are three things necessary in tawbah. How many things necessary in tawbah? Three things. Number one, first we must leave that sin. If you will commit any sin, when you will make tawbah, first thing what we must do, we must leave that sin. Pehle guna ko chhod do, jo guna ko hum kar rahe. Second thing, regretting our wrongdoing. Jo guna hum kar rahe hai na, uske upar kiya, uske upar sharmindagi aur nadam utho. We must feel sorry and sorrow in our heart. Allah, I did very wrong. If police will catch us and they will take us there, then you have to pay 100,000 rand. Now, then I will leave you, or I won't leave you. What will this be? This, how we will beg? How people will beg? Same thing we should do here also to Allah. Allah, please forgive me. Please forgive me. So that sorrow, that pain, how that pain will come that time? That pain should come in our heart. And number three, we must promise Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, I won't do again this guna. Now we can't remain on the promise what we will do. So many times we promise Allah, I won't do next time this guna, but still we are doing. We too should not worry about this thing. But we must promise now. And one thing Dr. Abdul Qadir mentioned, he said, we must make dua to Allah. Allah, please keep me on my promise. Stay fast, give me stay calm and stay fast on my promise. Like, oh, damn, I don't promise again this guna. We understand? There's three things we must do in tawbah. And when a person will make tawbah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will forgive it all sin. At-ta'ibu min ad-dhanbi kamalla dhanbala. A person who will make tawbah, he is like that person. He didn't commit sin. He didn't commit any sin. So we must make tawbah. What's that intention? What is tawbah? Tawbatan nasuha min. Takhlisuha min naqsiu wa fasad. तखलीसुहा मिन नक्सु व फसाद. के तौबा तो वो है जो हमारे सारे नुक्स मिलावट और फसाद से पाक हो. मीन्स तौबा, जब हम दिल से तौबा करें तो जबान से तौबा का लफ्ज इस्तेमाल करें तो हमारा दिल भी गवाही दे रहा हो, हमारा दिल भी हमारी जबान के साथ हो. When we will make तौबा, our heart also must be with our tongue. So what we are saying, Allah, please forgive me, and our heart also must say, I am making tawbah to Allah. This is tawbah. Is it tawbatan nasuha? So we must make tawbah. When a person will make tawbah, Allah will forgive all his son and shaitan and nafs. One story came, but time is short. About nafs. Just leave it now. One riwayat I mentioned now. Hazrat Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Once he was reading tahajjud salah every day. Only once he must tahajjud salah. He must tahajjud salah. Only once. Whole day he was crying. Allah please forgive me. Allah mujhe maaf kar de. Meri tahajjud ki namaz chhut gayi aaj. Meri tahajjud ki namaz chhut gayi. Allah mujhe maaf kar de. He was crying. Same day at night. That night shaitan came to him. He was sleeping. He said, wake up. Read your tahajjud salah. He said, who are you? He said, Muawiyah radiallahu anhu asked, who are you? He said, no, just you read tahajjud salah. Don't ask me who are you. He said, who? He said, I am shaitan, Iblis. He said, you are Iblis. You lead people to go astray. You lead people to don't read salah. And you are telling me read tahajjud salah. I don't understand. Tell me truth. What happened? Why did you come here? He said, no, you must do your work. Don't argue about it. You must do your work and read tahajjud salah. Don't ask me about it. He said, no, I won't leave you till you tell me the answer. Please tell me why you came here and wake me up for tahajjud salah. You are shaitan. Then he replied, bahut israr karne ki wajah se unhone jawab diya. Shaitan said, yesterday you did not read tahajjud salah, whole day you were crying, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave your very high status in Jannah. If you read tahajjud salah, you could not get that status which one you got, because you didn't read tahajjud salah and whole day you were crying. Agar wohi aap agar tahajjud padte, woh darja tumhe nahi mil sakta tha jo tumne pure din toba karke woh hasil kar liya. Main nahi chahta ki tumhe itna bada darja mil jaye jahannam mein, aap jannat mein. Main chahta hu ki isliye chahta hu ki aap is behtar hai ki aap tahajjud ki namaz padho, is behtar you need tahajjud salah. So we must make istighfar, we must make toba to Allah tabarak wa taala. What you are guna at night when we sleep, first three times we must say astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum wa atubu ilayhi. Three times Allah will forgive our all sins. And what thing we must do? First we must leave that guna. Second, regretting our wrongdoing. Third thing, we must promise I won't commit again the sin. I won't commit again the sin at night. And when you are, I mentioned two things, they are poisonous, our enemy, shaitan and nafs. Allah gave two, medication also, tawbah and istighfar. We must use this medication. Whenever any comment with guna on the same place, we must say astaghfirullah rabbi min kulli dhanbi wa atubu ilayh. So which land will bear witness of our guna? Same land will bear witness of our istighfar also. Allah, this land also will say he makes istighfar on this land. He committed guna on this land, on this earth, and same earth, the same land, he make istighfar also. उसी जमीन पर उसने इस्तेफार की, वही गवाही देंगे. तो हमें इस्तेफार करने की जरूरत है. We must say every night we must make istighfar. At night when sleep we must say three times astaghfirullah alladhi la ilaha illa huwa al-hayyul qayyum wa atubu ilayh. One thing we need to remember, our today our brother uncle Muhammad house today brand, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala grant him mehmul badal, Allah ta'ala grant better than these things. At night when we sleep, we must make amal on sunnah. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in riwayat, Ida nimtum fa'atufi'u surujakum. When you are going to sleep, you must off the candle, you must off all the extra lights, fanus, whatever we are using at night before we sleep, we must off it. That is all adab. We need to learn all sunnahs of sleeping, the way, sunnah way of sleeping. At night before we sleep, we must dust our bed also. Sometimes it happens, the snake there, what will happen? So then Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us, dust our bed also, read three times astaghfar, make wuzu, and we must off all extra lights also, candle also, then we must sleep. And one thing. Remember, look, I noticed one thing. The brother, he showed me one room. He kept one prayer me. He left all Quran and Kitab there. He was reading Salah there. That room did not burn. And that door also he left open. And Alhamdulillah, this thing became means of his protection. Okay, he came out from this door. He couldn't find key also. But he left this door also, and that was prayer room. He was reading Salah. MashaAllah, he was reading 5 times Salah. Or in Jamaat Khan, he read 5 times Salah also. He all Quran, Kitab didn't burn. And he could come out also. So that is why we must keep one prayer room in our, and keep Quran, Kitab. We must read Quran also in our house. This will be protection. So, and another dua, very good dua. If you will remember, Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala, time fee, Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, when fire was coming to his house, someone came to him. He said, go and protect your house, fire coming to your house. Somehow he said, no, I can't burn. My house can't burn. Second person came, he said, go and protect your house. The fire is coming to your house. He said, my house can't burn. Third person came, खुदा की कसम, अरे भाई दाएं तरफ से भी आग आई थी, बाईं तरफ से भी आग रही, जैसे तेरे घर पर आई आग बुझ गई. Coming from right side, left side, when came to your house, it went off. Said what? He said, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam taught us one dua. A person who will read the dua, who Abu Darda radiallahu anhu, the Sahabi. He said, when a person will read morning time the dua, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will protect him. From morning till evening time he will read, till morning, Allah will protect him. When Allah took responsibility, who can burn my house? No one can burn my house. Learn the dua. And every day read, Allahumma anta rabbi, la ilaha illa ant, alayka tawakkal, wa anta rabbil arshil kareem. Ma shaa Allahu kana, wa ma lam yashaa lam yakun, wa la hawla, wa la quwwata, illa billahi al-aliyyi al-azim. A'lamu anna Allaha ala kulli shay'in qadeer, wa anna Allaha qad ahata bi kulli shay'in ilma. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min sharri nafsi wa min sharri kulli dabba anta akhidun binasiyatiha inna rabbi ala sirati mustaqim. When I learn, Alhamdulillah, from that time to day I'm reading. So that's why I don't forget. Try to learn this dua. Read from morning. That morning time, every time, Allah will protect our family also, our house also, our shops also.